So I would like to tell some words about mathematics and mathematicians in Polish encyclopedias. Sorry for not speaking French, but my French is very bad, so it's better to speak English. Well, to discuss the problem of encyclopedias in Poland in the interwar period, one should take into account the political circumstances of the time. Since 1795, there existed no Poland as a foreign, as a sovereign state. Poland was partitioned by Russian Empire, the Kingdom of Prussia, and Habsburg Austria. In 1918, after the First World War, Poland regained its independence after 123 years. Well, the state and its institutions, in particular the whole system of science and education, should be restored. Universities in Krakow, Lwów, and Vilnius were re-established. The Polish University in Warsaw was opened. Beforehand, there was a Russian university. And a new university in Poznań was created. In 1918, was also established a private Catholic university in Lublin. It exists till today. The interwar period, between 1918 and 1939, was a time of intensive development of scientific research and education in Poland, in particular in mathematics. One should mention here Polish School of Mathematics with two main centers, Warsaw and Lwów. Main figures in Warsaw Mathematical Center were Wacław Sierpiński, Zygmunt Janiszewski, and Stefan Mazurkiewicz. They were the founders of the school. And further names, Karol Borsuk, Samuel Eilenberg, Kazimierz Kuratowski, were worldwide known. In Lwów, the main figures were Hugo Steinhaus, Stefan Banach, Stanisław Mazur, Hermann Auerbach, Kaczmarz, Łomnicki, Nikliborz, Orlicz, Ruziewicz, Sachs, Schauder, Ulam, and Leon Chwistek. He worked mainly in logic, but had a chair at the Faculty of Mathematics and Natural Sciences. Although mathematical logic and analytic philosophy have been developed in Poland at that time, one should mention here Lwów-Warsaw School of Philosophy, founded by Kazimierz Twardowski in Lwów, and Warsaw School of Logic. It was a branch, say, of those Lwów-Warsaw School of Philosophy. Founders of the School of Philosophy were Jan Łukasiewicz and Stanisław Leśniewski. And among main members of this school, one should mention Alfred Tarski, Adolf Lindenbaum, Mojżesz Pressburger, Mordechai Weisberg, Zygmunt Zawirski, Kazimierz Ajdukiewicz, Tadeusz Kotarbiński. As you see, most of them were Jewish and they were killed at the beginning of the Second World War. Except Tarski, who went to a conference just in August 39, and then rest in the state in US. In the interwar period, they have been published in Poland 9 universal encyclopedias and a number of subject and thematic ones. The most important universal encyclopedias were the following ones, namely Ilustrowana Encyklopedia Trzaski, Ewerta I Michalskiego, Illustrated Encyclopedia of Trzaska, Ewert and Michalski, 5 volumes and additional 6 volume supplement. Yeah. Secondly, Uniwersalna Powszechna Ultima Thule Encyklopedia, Ultima Thule Universal Encyclopedia, 10 volumes, published between 27 and 39, and Great Illustrated Universal Encyclopedia of Gutenberg, it was the name of the publisher, 20 volumes, as you see. One should mention here still one encyclopedia, the last one published completely before the Second World War. It had a special character. The title in translation, World and Life, an encyclopedic outline of contemporary knowledge and culture. 5 volumes. I will say some words about it later. Now there's a question. Which of those encyclopedias can be called national encyclopedias? So these encyclopedias considered as a national project in the sense that they have been supported by the government or connected to national institutes. The answer seems to be rather none of them. In fact, it is difficult to tell about national encyclopedias in Poland at that time. On the one hand, after the regaining the independence, there was a big social need for dictionaries and encyclopedias. On the other hand, the country was ruined and impoverished after the years of occupation and the war. Add that after the First World War, there took place another war, namely Polish-Soviet War, 1919-1920. Main task of the authorities was to integrate 3 parts of the country into one state. The parts so far function along different rules in 3 different state systems of annexationists. The needs for encyclopedias and dictionaries were met by private enterprises and private publishing houses. Note that all but one of the above mentioned encyclopedias have been published in Warsaw and only one in Krakow by private publishing houses. And now some words in details about those encyclopedias. We shall concentrate on the first one, Ilustrowana Encyklopedia Trzaskie, Werta i Michalskiego, published in 5 volumes in the period between 25 and 39, and supplemented by volume 6, coming from 1939. Here are some pictures, title page of the first volume, title page of the sixth volume, the supplement. Okay, why just this encyclopedia? It was the first encyclopedia published in the considered period. That's the first reason. It was finished and completely published before the Second World War. And it was the original Polish encyclopedia. Its editor, Stanisław Lam, writes in his remembrances that the aim of the publisher and the editor was to prepare an original work and not to limit the text to translations or reprints. The aim was to prepare an original Polish encyclopedia that could replace foreign ones, like encyclopedias of Brockhaus or Larousse, where information concerning Poland and Polish items were not always correct and objective. Well, the publication of the second encyclopedia, Encyklopedia Powszechna Ultima Thule, was not completed before the Second World War. Last volume ended by the entry Szymanowicz, that is by the letter S. The third encyclopedia, so-called Gutenberg Encyclopedia, had a compilatory character. Some entries were translated from German Encyclopedia Allgemeines Konwersationslexikon and from Meyer's Konwersationslexikon. Some Polish elements have been added, but it is claimed that it preserved in a certain sense its German character, so it was not original Polish one. Well, the editor of the Ilustrowana Encyklopedia Trzaskie Werta Michalskiego was, as I mentioned, Stanisław Lam. Who was Stanisław Lam? He was a critic and historian of literature. In the period 24-39, he was the editor-in-chief of the publishing house of Trzaska, Ewert and Michalski. And he writes in his remembrances that there were some difficulties to find authors and contributors. He succeeded and won 412 contributors to the encyclopedia. They were chosen by the editor-in-chief himself. Among members of the editorial board responsible for particular domains were 41 outstanding Polish scientists, mainly from Warsaw University and from Lwów University. as well as specialists from practical or artistic domains. They were listed in the first volume. For mathematics, responsible was Dr. Ludomir Wolfke, associate professor of Warsaw Technical University, specialist in descriptive geometry. Here is the page where those names are listed. Here is Wolfke at the very end. Yes. The encyclopedia was organized according to the alphabetic system. It is difficult and even impossible to say something about the authors of particular entries, because the entries were not signed. Hence, it is impossible now to determine the authors, to tell something about their nationality or about criteria that were adopted to select them. The Constituent Encyclopedia was published by Dom Księgarnia i Dom Wydawniczy Trzaska, Ewert and Michalski, bookstore and publishing house Trzaska, Ewert and Michalski. It was one of the biggest publishing houses, private one, in Poland at that time, founded in 1919 by booksellers Trzaska and Michalski, and by industrialist and senator Ludwig Józef Ewert, as public limited company. It acted till 1945. During the Second World War, its activity was suspended and limited to the sale of store inventory and second-hand bookstore. In 1945, it has been reactivated, and in 1951, the whole of its activity has been taken over by state-owned enterprises. It was the difficult time of Stalin. The bookstore existed till 1963. The publishing house specialized in publishing dictionaries, handbooks, and encyclopedias, works in various domains, including history, geography, culture, art, and literature. There were neither re-editions nor new editions of the encyclopedia we are considering. The encyclopedia seems to be a coherent work. One cannot observe any evolution of the approach during the time of publishing. It was an extensive encyclopedia. Particular volumes numbered between 520 and 660 pages, rather big ones. Moreover, the text contained numerous illustrations, both in black and white, and color, some on inserts. It turned out to be a successful enterprise with respect to both financial and editorial matters. So far, the general remarks concerning the encyclopedia, and now some words about way of presenting mathematics and mathematicians in it. Well, the encyclopedia contains about 400 entries devoted to mathematics, about 260 subject entries, and about 140 biographical ones. They are of medium length, but informative. Unfortunately, they are not signed, and other items of the encyclopedia. All entries present an actual state of knowledge. What should be stressed, there are no entries from the philosophy of mathematics, what is a bit amazing. Hence, one finds no information, for example, on logicism, formalism, or intuitionism. There is, of course, a general entry, mathematics, and entries devoted to particular domains of mathematics. What is the picture of mathematics in the encyclopedia? Let us start from the general entry, mathematics. We find there the following information. Mathematics, Greek, mathema, knowledge, is often commonly considered to be a knowledge about multitudes, especially about numbers and geometrical magnitudes. Nowadays, mathematical sciences are distinguished among other disciplines not by their subject, but only by their a priori character and deductive method they apply. It's a very interesting characterization of mathematics. Not subject, but method. Among branches of mathematics, the most developed are analysis and geometry, probability, theory of transformation groups, set theory, and mathematical logic. New disciplines stressed here, indicated. Furthermore, mathematics is divided into elementary and higher mathematics. A borderstone is a concept of a limit, borderstone between elementary and higher mathematics. Besides the pure theoretical mathematics, a number of branches of applied practical mathematics arose: geodesy, actuarial mathematics, mathematical statistics, biometrics. In particular, the aim of the actuarial mathematics is to give and justify rational methods that should be applied by any type of insurance. Here is the page for your mathematics, rather short entry. Yeah? Well, one should pay attention to the fact that mathematics was characterized not ontologically by its subject, but rather epistemologically by the method applied in mathematics. It is also worth noting that the rather new disciplines like set theory and mathematical logic were mentioned among few recently best developed branches of mathematics. What concerns domains of mathematics, they are entries special, separate entries devoted to classical ones such as algebra, analysis, arithmetic, geometry, differential integral calculus, calculus of variations, statistics, number theory, theory of functions, theory of differential and integral equations, theory of trigonometric series, topology, trigonometry. There are also new disciplines having special separate entries like set theory and mathematical logic. What is interesting, a new branch of mathematics launched by Polish mathematicians, I mean by Banach and his collaborators involved, that is functional analysis, is not mentioned at all. One doesn't find such entries in the encyclopedia. Maybe it was still too early to see its importance and meaning. Maybe. What about particular entries? Say, arithmetic at the beginning. One finds the information that the very name comes from Greek, and that arithmetic is divided into theoretical, elementary, commercial, and political arithmetic. The first one, theoretical, is described as knowledge about properties of numbers, a branch of higher mathematics. Elementary arithmetic is characterized in the following way. Elementary, this learning of calculating subject taught in lower and secondary schools contains a set of rules containing the notation of natural numbers and fractions, as well as arithmetical operations on them, together with the application of those rules to a practical life. Commercial arithmetic is described as the whole of mathematical knowledge helpful in trade relations. Political arithmetic contains basic knowledge from probability theory, actuarial mathematics, and mathematical statistics, political mathematics called. Well, there were also some historical information concerning the development of theoretical arithmetic. The introduction to various types of numbers and the process of generalizing the concept of number are described from the very beginnings by primitive people to the concept of complex numbers and the axiomatization due to Hilbert. Geometry. One finds the following explanation. Geometry, Greek, literally knowledge of measurement of length. This name has now only a historical meaning because the measurement of length is nowadays a subject of geodesy. The subject of geometrical investigations are properties of spatial objects, geometrical figures. Well, the beginnings of geometrical knowledge gained by experimental way one finds in ancient Egypt. Geometry was made a mathematical science only by Greeks. Such are the explanations there. Greeks developed geometry to higher level. A rapid development of geometry started in the 17th century. New research methods have been developed and geometry has been divided into a number of branches. And there are some branches listed there, namely elementary geometry. Its subject are elementary geometry figures like lines, planes, cycles, etc. A branch of it is trigonometry together with goniometry. Synthetic geometry, descriptive geometry, analytic geometry, differential, topology, and foundations of geometry, where axiomatic systems of geometry are investigated. There is also another classification given, namely planimetry, stereometry, and multidimensional geometry. Such classifications are proposed as well. What is interesting, in the whole set of mathematical entries in the encyclopedia, stress is put just on geometry. It is the longest entry, many entries devoted to particular geometrical concepts. What was the reason of it? Maybe the fact that the member of the editorial board responsible for mathematics was a specialist just in geometry, and it was his special discipline. All entries have a similar structure. After the explanation of what the subject of a given domain is and how it is divided, they are given some historical remarks. There are no bibliographical information, with the exception of geometry. Only in geometry there are some bibliographical information. It should be noted that mainly Polish literature is provided, and if a foreign work is quoted, then only its Polish translation is given. From foreign authors, mostly mentioned is Enrique. Well, besides entries devoted to domains of mathematics, there are also entries devoted to particular concepts. They are of elementary character. So far, the main entries devoted to mathematics as a whole and to its branches. Now, some words about biographical entries devoted to mathematicians. Well, there are such entries concerning both Polish as well as foreign mathematicians. All periods of the history are covered. The partition by country is the following. Norway, one person. France, 26 mathematicians. England, 12. Italy, 6. Switzerland, 2. Germany, 29 mathematicians. The Netherlands, 1. Russia, 2. Antiquity and Middle Ages, 16. So you see that German and French mathematicians are preferred. There is more entries devoted to them. The entries are longer than other ones. Why? Could it be the fact that encyclopedias edited by Lam reminded, in a way, publications of Brockhaus? Maybe. Surprisingly, there are no entries devoted to Bolyai, Bradwardinus, Diophantus, Bull, De Morgan, Piano, no such entries. Why? Don't know. Almost all Polish mathematicians, old and contemporary, with few exceptions, have their entries. There are not so many entries devoted to Polish mathematicians, and it is clear, understandable. In fact, before the 20th century, there were few known Polish mathematicians, so maybe 10 persons maximum. Only in the interwar period, mathematics has been intensively developed in Poland. So one finds in the encyclopedia names of all founders of Polish School of Mathematics, both in Warsaw and in Lwów. What is a bit amazing is the lack of an entry devoted to Stefan Badach, probably the best known Polish mathematician. The reason can be the fact that he started his academic career in the 20s. His main work, the monograph Théorie des Opérations Linéaires, was published in 1932. Thanks to this book, his results have been popularized among mathematicians and contributed to the development of functional analysis. He gained world recognition in the 30s, and the first volume of the encyclopedia was published in the end of 20s, so it was, say, maybe too early. There are some entries devoted to contemporary Polish mathematicians whose names have been forgotten today, because they did not play an important role in mathematics, but they were important at the time when the encyclopedia was published. There are also entries devoted to logicians, mathematical logicians in particular, both foreign and Polish. Important figures of Polish logic have been have their special entries, in particular main representatives of Warsaw School of Logic, Jan Łukasiewicz and Stanisław Leśniewski. What should be noticed, the entry devoted to Leśniewski is very, very short. I don't know why. There are also entries devoted to Kazimierz Twardowski, the founder of the whole school, and to some old Polish logicians. So far, the biographical entries. In all entries devoted to mathematics and its domains, a combination of a genetic and substantial, say, approaches can be seen, a combination of them. In all entries, the stress is put on classical issues. There are rather no new theories or theorems mentioned, with very few exceptions. Entries are rather short, classical, factual, and objective. They are philosophically neutral. No particular philosophical tendency is preferred. There are no different mathematical levels. All entries are at, say, school teacher level. Polish disciplines, say so-called Polish disciplines, developed in the 20s, are present, in particular topology, set theory, foundations of mathematics, as well as mathematical logic. Functional analysis is not mentioned. I stressed it beforehand. However, the contribution of Polish mathematicians and logicians is not specially stressed. It's not stressed. The only few words about set theory and topology. Possible reason, Polish mathematicians just have begun to work in those domains. No names of Polish mathematicians being active in them have been mentioned. However, there are biographical entries devoted to them. Both classical logic and, well, yeah. Both classical logic and mathematical logic are presented in general general. Wait a minute. Okay. Just this one. Are present in the encyclopedia. The structure of main entries is similar as it was the case of mathematics. Namely, this explanation of the subject and some words about the origins and the historical development. No biographical information, not bibliographical information is provided. One finds also biographical entries of founders of Warsaw School of Logic, Łukasiewicz, Leśniewski, as well as Twardowski. The very logic is explained as a discipline about formal foundations, elements and laws of thought. Formal logic is first of all a science about concepts, propositions and corollaries. As the founder of logic is mentioned Aristotle. Mathematical logic, call it according to the entry in the encyclopedia, symbolic logic, logistic, algebra of logic, is described as a part of formal logic built by a strictly deductive method. It is the simplest deductive system, constitutes the foundation of the whole mathematics. It is characterized in comparison with the classical logic by exactness and the richness of new laws. Yes. As was the case of mathematics, entries are rather short and of dictionary character, and they explain also various logical concepts. In some entries devoted to mathematics, there are remarks concerning connections of presented items with applications, technology, and generally practice. So far, the encyclopedia is the most important encyclopedia of Trzaska, Evert, and Michalski. Maybe a few words about the logic here. And mathematical logic, you see, very short entries. The last encyclopedia published before the Second World War was this Word and Life, an encyclopedic outline of contemporary knowledge, 5 volumes. This was not a universal encyclopedia, but it's worth of mentioning here. It had a specific and rather non-standard character. In fact, it was a collection of survey entries from various fields ordered alphabetically. It was meant, first of all, for pupils and students, but could serve, of course, a large public. Particular entries in volumes 1 to 4 were written by eminent Polish scholars. Entries in volume 5 were not signed. Here's title page, and here, well, you know, among entries in the main part, the first 4 volumes, devoted to mathematics and its branches, one finds the following ones. Arithmetic and algebra, written by Tadeusz Sierzputowski, function by Otto Nikodym, geometry, also Otto Nikodym, number and numeral, Otto Nikodym, mathematics, Hugo Steinhaus, special entry logic, written by Kazimierz Ajdukiewicz. There are some pages. Well, other branches of mathematics were presented in the additional volume 5. Among them, you know, analysis, algebra, etc., etc. So far, this one. And now I move to the last item, namely, to this thing. Presenting Polish encyclopedias in the interwar period, one should say some words about Poradnik dla Samouków. Guide for Autodidacts, a special publication, present only in Poland, I suppose. Well, 2 volumes were devoted to mathematics, volume 1, published in 1915, and volume 3, published in 1923. It had an encyclopedic character. Well, its aim was to facilitate the learning on the level of higher education and to prepare for scientific research. Michalski, who was the publisher, gained eminent Polish scientists, mostly young and creative persons, for the enterprise. The most active among mathematicians was just Zygmunt Janiszewski, one of the founders of Warsaw School of Mathematics. The book had an encyclopedic form. The main idea was to provide possibly full information on particular branches of mathematics, taking into account the current state of research and literature. Here in the title page. The main authors of particular items in volume 1 devoted to mathematics were, and you see here, famous Polish mathematicians, and many very interesting entries. Jan Łukasiewicz on science, general subject. Zygmunt Janiszewski wrote about, well, general introduction is not so important, ordinary differential equations, function, difference, and integral equations, expansions into series, topology, foundations of geometry, logistic, philosophical problems of mathematics. Stefan Kwietniewski about geometrical issues and history of mathematics in general, history of mathematics in Poland. Wacław Sierpiński about arithmetic and number theory. Stanisław Zaremba, analytic functions, partial differential equations, etc. Mazurkiewicz, probability theory. Every chapter contained an extensive bibliography containing both classical monographs as well as current scientific papers, also Polish once published in journals. It should be noted that the authors of the volume highly valued the foundations of mathematics and mathematical logic. This was perhaps the result of close collaboration of Polish mathematicians and logicians that took place just in Warsaw. It was a specific thing of Polish school. Here is the third volume devoted to mathematics also, and one had here the following items. Jan Śleszyński on the meaning of logic for mathematics, on first stages of the development of the concept of infinity. Mazurkiewicz, set theory in relation to other branches of mathematics, typical Polish items. Kazimierz Żorawski on applications of the theory of transformation groups, and Zaremba on the mutual relation of mathematics and physics. Both volumes, first and third, gave the competent picture of particular branches of mathematics and of their development, as well as of interrelations between them. They gave also methodic hints how to study mathematics. To make it easier and to facilitate the usage of literature, Zygmunt Janiszewski gave in his introductory chapter a table indicating the partition of mathematics into particular branches and the mutual interrelations between them. The table is also interesting from the philosophical point of view. It shows how Polish mathematicians understood mathematics and the relations of mathematics to other disciplines, in particular to logic and set theory. Here is the famous table. What is important here, namely, we have the traditional partition into geometry on the one hand and analysis on the other, analysis together with algebra and geometry. What is interesting is the fact that in this table, between geometry and analysis, one finds set theory and group theory. Yes. Yes. Reading the table from the top to the bottom, one sees set theory at the top, then foundations of arithmetic, foundations of geometry and topology. In this way, set theory was granted the dominating and leading position. It's very important, very characteristic of Polish mathematicians. This indicates the position and the role attributed by Polish mathematicians to set theory and to mathematical logic. They provided the foundations of mathematics in the methodological sense, just set theory and mathematical logic. It is worth noting here also that in the introduction to volume one, Janiszewski explains the aims of mathematics. He tries to answer the question, what are the purposes of the whole edifice of such abstract knowledge as mathematics? And he answers, usually as a raison d'etre of mathematics, one mentions the applications of it, in particular its influence on the development of technology that was possible only thanks to the modern mathematics. But he adds also that there are elements of beauty in mathematics and that it can be in the best way compared with the beauty of music and architecture, with the harmony of tones and lines. Yes, so far Janiszewski. Time for conclusion. One can see that, the state after the regaining of independence and all the institutions of the state, in particular the whole system of science and education, should be restored after the First World War. There was a big hunger for education and for scientific as well as didactic literature, in particular for encyclopedias. And there was, of course, great enthusiasm among scholars to write and to prepare new books. One should mention here intensive development of scientific research and education in Poland, in particular in mathematics and in mathematical logic. One should mention, as I did, Polish School of Mathematics, and also mathematical logic, analytic philosophy, Lwów-Warsaw School of Philosophy, and Warsaw School of Logic. All encyclopedias were published by private publishing houses. They were private enterprises, no state ones. Eminent scholars were engaged anonymously, no names given. the role and meaning of mathematics have been estimated at their proper values in all those encyclopedias, in particular in the one I have presented here in details. Mathematics itself, as well as its branches, have been characterized well, with competence and in a modern way. Also, new mathematical disciplines have been regarded, such as set theory, topology, and mathematical logic. Usually, historical and bibliographical comments have been supplemented with emphasis put on Polish works. So far, this is the summary. Thank you very much.